right now, we're headed for a state championship. But it's not going to be easy. Ain't nobody going to lay down. We know they're going to play us that much harder.
This is it. I mean, we got, I don't know, I think close to 30 seniors, and everybody's had playing time last year and the year before that. So a lot of experience coming onto the field this year, and hopefully we can put it all together.
Man, if I get that, man, all dreams since I was a little kid, state championship, and that big rock on my finger, all come down to success.
You got to dream big and then find a way to accomplish your dreams.
Blue 98. How are you handling those expectations going into the season?
Well, we're handling pretty good. The kids is up for the season. They're all excited and they're ready to go. The main thing I got to do is just keep them motivated and keep them ready to go, you know. They'll get down on themselves, but we got to keep them pumped up, keep them ready to play.
Working hard, got experienced offense and defense, good group of seniors coming back, and we're just working hard, ready for the season. We've been looking forward to this since last year, ready to get on the field.
Now, this is your fourth year starting now.
Yes, sir.
You've been here a while. You've been through the trials and tribulations. Now this is your team. You're the front row leader. What's it like to have that responsibility?
It's a great responsibility. It's fun, and it's fun to lead these guys on the field every Friday night, and have them come behind me. You know, we got to play hard. You know, we're gonna play hard, nothing less.
Oh, there you go.
We looking to have a wonderful defense this year. Man, everybody talking about how fast our defense going to be. And most of our defense has returned. We only lost like four seniors. So we pretty big up front, looking to stop the run and, you know, become first in 3A. Looking for a state championship. Oh, man, I'm excited to play Philly, Jim Hill, and Wickasee County. Yeah, so that's like, trying to new competition and everything. I like to see all the new talent out in the world. So I'm ready to face them teams, especially Knoxville County, because, you know, we all got rivals there. Everybody rivals. So I'm ready to face them teams and be ready for the season.
We are back for night number two of the End Zone Preview Shows.
Well, I'm excited to see Louisville. 30 seniors returning to that team. They should be fun to watch. I don't want to go ahead and say that Louisville is going to run away with everything, though. There are some other teams in our area that can challenge them, some good teams in the South in 3A.
Who got the state championship for Class 3A this season?
Louisville.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
If you had a chance to see Louisville in that, I know it's a jamboree game, but they played West Point this past week. If you saw them, they put up 35 points in one half against West Point's defense in a jamboree. Louisville's winning 3A, I'm sorry.
It ain't gonna be no easy walk, but we're just gonna have to hold up to the task. We play in Philadelphia and we play in Wilkinson County in the regular season. And then you got Charleston up there, then you got Water Valley, then you got Aberdeen. All those guys are pretty tough there, you know. And so it's not gonna just, nobody gonna lay down and just let it go. So we know we got to work hard to get there and got to be ready to play.
Louisville, just your ordinary 47-0 win.
I'm ready. The only thing about
it, ain't got to play. You ready?
Hey, you're the one that got to play. You're the one that got to play.
Caught him. Rose right through.
through soon.
Louisville, they're still perfect as well as they beat Kosciuszko 28-0. Teams in Class 3A between Louisville and Water Valley. A whole lot of points were scored in this one, ladies and gentlemen. First quarter, this is a 4th-and-1 play. DeMarcus Brooks taking off and jogging, it looks like. A 50-yard touchdown. Wildcats already out to a 7-0 lead. Blue Devils have a 13-7 lead, but that just made Louisville mad, and you don't like them when they're mad. Wyatt Roberts up top. Dante Jones, how about this catch? Over the top of the defender. 60 yards later, Dante's in the end zone for the score. It's a 14-13 lead at this point for Louisville. And like we said, this just made Louisville mad. And DeMarcus Brooks had the game of his life tonight. He scored 4 touchdowns in the first half running ball. And, Coach, I know you love it when you see good hard-nosed running like this.
You mentioned the offensive line. He scored 4 touchdowns, and you had 5 guys up front blocking all night long, and that's kudos to that offensive line knocking back.
They did a great job tonight, and that's why Louisville is your winner, 56-27. Wildcats move on, stay unbeaten. They are now 13-0.
Wants to throw, now calls his own number. Swinging to the left side, he's got some room. Roberts, oh wow, does he punish the defensive back there.
Good gracious.
Thought he was a running back. First and goal to go.
They're leading by 7 and trying to knock on the door again, and they will. Touchdown.
And that's Sangster.
Yeah,
where'd he come from? Yeah, the Indians, now the ball goes up in the air and it's gonna be picked off. That's why they run the tip drill back in the summer.
And look who it is.
Yeah, Sangster.
Another Sangster. This time, Jalen Sangster.
Here's Roberts, wants to throw, steps up in the pocket, it's got a man. That is a touchdown.
What a throw.
Desmond Goss and Roberts put it right on the money. Warner, two-step drop, down the middle, and it's caught.
Wow.
And that is a touchdown by Reese. What a throw by Warner, and a heck of a catch.
They're on their own 1 yard line. They'll go with the I formation, and Warner does want to throw it. It's blocked down and picked up in the end zone, and he's knocked out of the end zone.
Boy, and that's a safety.
Yes. The Wildcats will go for it on 4th down and 6. This time a low snap. Roberts rolling. Roberts looking, has his man for a first down at the 23. Shakes the tackle, trying to get into the end zone, and will for the touchdown.
Wow. Dante Jones, just an outstanding one-on-one play.
First and goal from the 2 now off the penalty. And they're just kind of pushing the pile forward. There it is, touchdown. Bunch of receivers to the right. Warner looking, Warner trying to turn it up the field. It's got a man out there, spins away, and it's gonna be a touchdown.
This ball in the air.
Twin receivers both ways. Warner wants to throw, ball knocked down. The Wildcats knock it down, and Slaughter, Malik Slaughter, who has done that several times in the second half. There's your ball game. 7 seconds to go. The Wildcats are pouring out onto the field, and the Louisville Wildcats are your 3A state champion. It was a great football game.
This is the third one I was part of, but I was part of 1-9 and 1-9 and 3.
in this one. I was the defensive coordinator in them two. So now I'm the head coach, and this is just a great opportunity for Louisville to keep getting focused, you know.
You had some good history here in Jacksonville. You just keep winning when you come here. What's this Baptist magic where you just get here and win gold balls?
Well, I hope it stay that way, too. I don't know how much longer I'm going to stay in it, but right now I'm going to be in it for a few more years, and I've been coaching 40 years. And so I'm going to stay three or four more. As long as I can jump up and down, hoop and holler, and race everything, young boy, I think I'll be all right.